Now let's look at the row labels part of a pivot table. At the moment you can see we've pulled through the month, and the month is split by January, February, March, and we have some values associated with it. With the rows, you're not limited to only one label, you can have more than one. So for example, I've got something here called day of month. If I click it and drag it down, you'll see the little blue line there. I'm going to put it after the month. When I let go, you'll see what it does is I've now got two row labels, one being the month, and the second part of that is the day of the month. So you'll see this is January 25th, 26th, etc., February 1st, 2nd, 3rd. You can move this around. So for example, if I take the day of the month and I rather put it above the month, let go. Now what this is saying is the first days of the month for February, those were the answers. For March, those were the answers. For the second day of the month, February, March, etc. Let's just pull it back here. Another thing to notice about the row labels is that above the row is a little drop-down box. And if I click on it, I get a number of options. So you can see there's some sorting options, and we'll deal with these a little bit later. And there's some filter options, so you'll see if there were value filters, we could do that. And then you'll see at the moment we've selected all and it's showing January, February and March. But for example, we can easily go and say I don't want January, I don't want March, and when I say OK, you'll see those disappear. So we can be quite specific on what we want to show. I'll just switch those back on. Say OK. And you'll see each row label will have a drop down. Depending what's in them, certain other options will become available. As with all things Excel, if you click on one of these row labels and you right click, you'll see you have a number of options. And I just want to look at this for now, the field settings. When I click field settings, you'll see we get this. You can see at the moment Excel has automatically chosen a label for the row, called it month, but you can change it. Another useful thing to see is you've got something here called subtotals, and you can see it's set as automatic. What that means is it has automatically decided that it will take these numbers and in this case sum them. You can change or decide what you want to see here. So if I click none and I say OK, just watch what happens here. You'll see the subtotal disappears. Let me right click here, go to field settings. There's also something called custom. So if I can click on custom, you'll see I now can say please sum all the items or count them. So I can go to count, say OK, and you'll see what it's doing now is not summing these items, but counting how many items exist here. Again, I come here, and it's quite important. If I went to this row label and I right clicked and I said field settings, we've got a different set of field settings because each row label has its own field settings. So let me go back here, I right click, go to field settings. What's quite nice as well is if, for example, I'm on count at the moment but I switch sum on, you'll see they both stay highlighted. And maybe let me put average on as well, and let's go overboard, max and min. When I say OK, you now get all these details relating to those items. So it's given me the sum of those items, the count of them, what the average is, what the maximum number is, and what the minimum number is. Just going back there, let's go back to our automatic option. Let's right click on the row label again, go to field settings. Let's look at this one now, the layout and print. And you'll see at the moment it's ticked as show item labels in tabular form. And this is what tabular form means. If I said please show the item labels in outline form, we'll get onto what these do now. When I say OK, you'll see how the pivot table looks changes. Just go back in there, layout and print. Maybe I want to say please display labels from the next field in the same column, something called compact form. If you watch what happens here, when I say OK, you'll see basically the columns now are a lot closer together. Okay, right click, field settings. You'll see we can also say please display the subtotals at the top of each group. At the moment the subtotals are at the bottom. If I click on that and say OK, you'll see they switch to the top. Go back to field settings, layout and print. Let's go back to the show items in tabular form. You'll see you can also set it up so that it inserts a blank line after each item label. So when I switch it on and I say OK, you'll see what it does is it creates a blank line between each individual item. Right click, field settings. You can also specify to show items with no data. By default, the pivot table, if there's no data for a particular item, won't show that item. You can actually insist that it does show the item. You can see here as well that you can ask it to insert a page break after each item. So if you did this and printed it out, this section will be printed, there'd be a page break over here, and this will be printed on a new page. Let's see what else you can do with the row labels. If I right click, you'll see one of the options here is something called sort. You'll see you've got a couple of options, sort A to Z, Z to A, or more sort options. Let's just get out of this. As mentioned earlier, pivot tables are their own animal, and they basically live outside of the spreadsheet, so they sit on top of the spreadsheet. What that means is if I come, for example, to February, and if I go and change the cursor to that little four-directional arrow, if I click, hold, and I move it up, notice the little dashed line. What this means is I'm now going to manually sort this, so I want February to appear above January. When I take it to the top and I let go, every item that belongs to February moves up with it. So that's manual sorting. And I can do the same thing, click, change the cursor, and move it to the top. Let's say for whatever reason I decide that the day 5 should not exist before or after day 1, click, move it to the top, and you'll see now my sort order is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. And notice that for all the months, that sort order has been applied. So that is manual sorting. However, when I right click, when I say sort, you'll see I've got a couple of other options. So it says sort A to Z. When I click on it, you'll see it sorts it in ascending order, January, February, March. If I right click again and go sort, Z to A, you'll see it goes backwards. But probably more interesting is when I go sort and I ask for more sort options. What you'll see is we get this. So we can switch back to go manual, which means that we can drag and drop it. We can go ascending or descending, but very important, you'll see at the moment it's saying ascending by month. What that means is it's going to sort it in ascending, but it'll use the month's row label to decide what the order is. We don't have to use that. If I click here, I can say please use the sum of bill rather. So go from the lowest to the highest based on the sum of bill. So if I look here, when I say OK, what it's done is January now is the front, because it has the lowest sum of bill, 184. Next is March, because it's got 915. And last is February, because it's 1138. Perhaps you want to do it at this level. I come here, I right click, I say sort. You'll see it gives you, because it's recognized that it's a number, it now says sort from smallest to largest, or largest to smallest. I can say more sort options. In this case, let's go descending. And I want to go descending, not by the day of the month, so I don't want to see 31, 30, 28. I want to base it on the count. So go in descending, show me the highest count here. When I say OK, you'll see it's now sorted these items based on the count. You may also notice that in the row labels, you'll see next to these items is a little minus sign. Very useful. If in this case I'm not actually interested in seeing this detail, I can click and you'll see it's all closed and I've got my totals. If I now want to see the detail, I click and it's all shown. If you right click on one of these, you'll see there's something here called expand and collapse. I can either expand or collapse individually, or let us collapse the entire field. You'll see all of those close, and now I just see January, March, February. If I want to expand, I say expand the entire field, and you'll see that is brought through.